Hey guys, my name is Caitlin and welcome to another video. Today I am going to be doing a little bit of a rant review. I have just finished up a book that I honestly thought I was going to love, and that could not be further from the truth. I am of course talking about Sky in the Deep by Adrienne Young. Oh man, I have a lot to say about this book. However, as I do with my full book reviews, I will make sure that there is a spoiler-free section and a spoiler-filled section. Oh man, it's not good. Guys, I don't know if it's just me, I don't know if it was just overhyped completely, or if I am just not getting what everyone else is, but this was not good. Not for me, dog. No, this had glaring issues I could not look past. All right, so let me just hop right into trying to explain this book spoiler-free. This book is about a girl named Elin who is a Viking warrior at just 17 in her tribe, which has been at war with another tribe from the mountains for millennia, all dating back to their gods who had a hatred for each other, and so every 5 years they engage in battle on this specific battlefield. And we are following essentially the chief's daughter, and that's kind of where we're at in the book. I would love to tell you that there's a plot beyond this, but there's not. Hey guys, it is editing Caitlin here, and I just was going to give you guys a little bit of a disclaimer. This is a fairly harsh review, and I don't want anyone to think that I disvalue their opinion. I think that everyone has different opinions, and that's totally fine. If you loved this book, that is great. I just didn't, and so I just wanted to make that clear that I am not trying to say that anyone's views on this book, if they liked it, are not valid or worthy. And as someone who has been into YA for most of my life, and that being a genre that people shit on kind of constantly, I have a lot of sympathy and empathy towards people who like things that others don't. So I don't want anyone to feel that way. I do get a little harsh on this one. I was very passionate about it, but yeah, that's just kind of my little two cents. Oh, also my video for some reason cuts out for like 45 seconds to a minute in the beginning here. Just a warning, it sucked. I don't know why the rest of the video was fine, but yeah, that's a thing. So forgive me, and yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. So without giving anything away, let's kind of hop into a few of the reasons why this book just is not good at all, and why I ended up not liking it at all. The fight scenes. The fight scenes absolutely were lacking. There was confusion as to what was happening, which I have read a lot of fight sequences in a lot of different books, and you can focus on one person's perspective and still get a general idea of everything that's going on around that person, what they're thinking, what they're seeing, and have the battlefield itself make sense. That is not this. There's also a lot of battle sequences that have really no stakes in them, because you have two battle sequences in the first like 40 pages and they're completely separate events, and you do not have any stake in the characters or the culture or the world at all to even care that they're happening. My second reason I did not like this book at all, the characters were so single-minded and just completely flat. There was no nuance to these characters, and they really did not have any personalities beyond the one singular trait that they were supposed to represent. And I find that so upsetting, because literally the quote on the front of the book is, "Fascinating multidimensional characters in a starkly beautiful world." No, it is not multidimensional, even in the slightest. I think what it was is that people liked the theme of the book, which I'll get to later, because I also had problems with that. And they tried to say that since the theme was exploring multidimensional people, that the characters were then multidimensional, and that is not the case. These guys were stale as white bread, left out for a few days. They had no personality. It was just bad. I will go into a little bit more on this in the spoiler section, because again, I don't want to give anything away in case like you hear me rant about all this and then you're like, nah, that sounds good, I can deal with it. But regardless, the third thing I really disliked about this book is the theme, which I just mentioned. The theme is kind of a classic one when you have warring tribes, and I don't feel like I'm giving anything away by telling you what it is, which is just trying to learn more about your enemy and realizing that they are people too and they have their own motivations and such, and that you can come to an understanding as human beings. There's a very, very big reason why this doesn't work that I'll get to, but ultimately it just ends up falling completely flat and being very uninspired. And I don't know, I've seen it done so many times and done so many times better in other books and other pieces of media in general, that this just felt like a crappy summary of like the actually good stories that have those themes. The fourth thing I hated was that the author seemed confused or like it wasn't edited enough, because I found several just laughable mistakes within the writing and with like plot inconsistencies that I was just like, wait, I'm sorry. What? That's not what just happened. Or like, that doesn't make sense that this character just said that, because it directly contradicts something that was said earlier. It was ridiculous, and I'll give an example later, but yeah. Oh, and you know what? I just lied, because that wasn't the last thing I hated. The last thing I hated was the romance. The romance was not good. This is supposed to be an enemies to lovers kind of thing, and no. There are certain things I'm willing to look past as far as an enemies to lovers trope goes. There's usually a point where they start to learn about each other as people and play off of each other. There's a dynamic and they start to see redeeming qualities in the other person. There's moments of bonding throughout the way. They get a common enemy. They are forced to interact in ways that are very camaraderie building, I guess, in a way. And there was just none of that in this book. It was enemies to lovers with no development whatsoever. They don't even like hang out that much. Like they just don't. And I didn't see a single scenario in which they would have any reason to start liking each other. They just suddenly did. And there was no build up to it. Like maybe I just blocked it out of my memory because I just like, this whole book felt like reading a fever dream, or like I was drunk and trying to recall what I had done last night when I was blacked out. But like, it just wasn't good. There was no development. And by the point in which they became lovers, I had to ask myself, why? Why do you stop? Why did you stop hating each other? I didn't even stop hating either of you. I mean, I don't think you're like characters enough. Like there's nothing about you to even hate really, because you're not a person, you're just a cardboard cutout. But yeah, it was bad. It was not good. And I love an enemies to lovers trope, and this is not it, dog. It's not it. All right, I'm gonna launch into some spoilers here just because I think to really fully encapsulate just how bad this is, I need to talk about it in more explicit terms. So if you do plan on reading this or you don't trust me for some reason, stop watching now. We'll get to it later. Going back to the fight sequences that I mentioned earlier, Elin is like not that good of a fighter, and neither is her like warrior partner or at all either. And then like they just stop fighting halfway through and then they start up again whenever the raid on Fila happens, which is also just like not interesting. I feel like they tried to set up something interesting with the woman going into labor at the same time the attack was happening, but it wasn't interesting, and I didn't care about any of those things happening at all. Also, the reason why they were fighting was because one of the gods made the mountain people, and the god of the plains and the sea didn't like that and was jealous. So he made his people fight them. That's it. That is literally the only explanation that they give you for the reason why these two tribes have been fighting every 5 years for the past forever. That's it. That's the only information that they give you on that. And there isn't even like a cooler, subtle, hidden reason below that as to why they have a blood feud. No. Oh, also she got injuries and like Eerie got injuries throughout the whole thing, and I had to remind myself how the fuck they got them, because I didn't remember anything happening in the battle sequences because they were just so confusing and just like not well edited that I was just like, there's was no way that this actually happened, right? And I had to go back and like be like, oh yeah, you know that one off sentence where they play the pronoun game? Yeah, that's where that happened. You could have fooled me. So as a whole, the fight sequences are just uninspired, and the reasoning and motives behind why they're at war are absolutely laughable. It was like the author wanted these two people to hate each other fundamentally, but didn't want to put in the work to figure out why they hated each other fundamentally, because that would be too much world building. And there is no world building in this. That is absolutely against the rules. In fact, when you get to the actual big bad, which is just, I guess, evil incarnate and demons, I don't know. I think they're people. Like, they treat them like people, but like, they never actually... What the fuck are the Herja? There's not even an explanation of who they are, what they are, or their motives at all. Because again, that's too much world building, so you just have to trust them that when they are fighting, that they're the good guys. It's so black and white and stupid that I genuinely thought I was losing brain cells. On to the characters. Elin is our main character. She has the notable qualities of being an Asuka, having a brother, and liking to fight. I couldn't tell you another goddamn thing about her. I don't know what she likes, I don't know what she dislikes outside of the enemy tribe, which I forgot the name of because I don't care. I cannot tell you why the boy, whatever his name, fell in love with her. I don't know why she fell in love with him. I know she has a dead mom and a supposedly dead brother that's not actually dead, and that she's mad at him because he switched sides. That's it. And I honestly, like, if I just completely read her wrong, please let me know in the comments, but I don't think there's another trait I could give her. No. There's nothing about her that's interesting. It's like she's supposed to be a stand-in for, like, a reader, like those old reader inserts fan fictions. It's like that's who she is as a character, where she has no discernible personality traits, and that's it. Any stereotypical young adult female that's supposed to be just like, she's badass and fights her own battles, that's Elin. And then they gave her nothing beyond that. Like, even with Feyre, who's kind of a basic bitch, at least they gave her painting and, like, a personality beyond that of a stick. All right, anyway, let's go ahead and get into the theme. And the theme is basically like, hey, we're not so different after all. Maybe we shouldn't be having a war because we're both good people at heart. And we've just been doing this, but maybe we were wrong. And we're all good people and we can all live happily in society. Which, again, as I said before, it was done better in other forms of media and books in general, and this was just a really bad children's drawing summary of that plot. So it was not good. It wasn't good. And it was also completely defeated when they brought in the Herja, who is another people, I think? Who's another just like people or demon race, I don't know. They never describe that or go into detail at all. But they bring in this other warring nation, and then they are like, they completely forget the moral of the story or the theme that they were going for, because they're like, see, we're not all different, we're all just people, we're good and evil, and that's okay, we're not that different. And then these people come in and they're like, those people though, those people are different and evil. And we don't need to know anything about them or their motives to know that they are bad people. And we need to destroy all of them and kill all of them. And then we can all be happy with our two tribes that we just learned are so alike. It's so bad. Like, did you forget the theme? The theme is supposed to be that, like, people are people and y'all are not that different. And there are good people on each side and you're fighting over nothing. And I guess I learned that you were fighting over nothing, but oh my god, what? Who are the Herja? I feel like I've asked that a few times in this video, but like that's so frustrating to me that I can't even answer that for you. I can't tell you if they're demons or if they're people, because they say that they're men and women and that they sleep and everything. They just have weird colored eyes that they're white and stuff. But like, they're people, they can talk. She pulled an eye out of one of them and he like was tortured and everything, so they're people. What's the point of this story and this theme? I remember now. So The author seemed a lot of times confused as to what was happening, and obviously there was a problem with like editing or something, because there were full scenes that got totally contradicted, and it feels like a lot of the development of the two main love interests just got cut out entirely. On page 148, it says, "Eerie met my eyes one last time before he lifted himself up onto his horse, but I kept them cold, hard. I wasn't going to give him an unspoken goodbye any more than he would beg for one. He turned his horse and started down the path toward the other. They disappeared around the bend, and I rubbed my palms against my chest. It would be the last time I'd ever see him, in this life or the next." Flash forward to page 163, and it says, "I opened my eyes when the door opened, and the weight of more blankets pressed down on top of me. Eerie was asleep next to the fire, his head propped up on his saddlebag." What the fuck? You just lied! Like, that was just, you just said, that would be the last time I ever saw him again, in this life or the next. And then he was there, like 10 pages later, 20 pages, I don't care. I don't care. It's just so unimaginably wrong. And I know you could make the argument that like, oh, that was her narration in the moment and she thought she was never gonna see him again because she planned to escape. No, I'm sorry. That is not the way to phrase that then. And it just makes the whole thing confusing. And if you had edited that correctly, that would have been implicit of the reasoning and the meaning, but that wasn't how it read. There was that, and then there were also points in which, like, they would reference something happening in the town, the villa that they were at, that I just, like, straight up was like, that didn't happen. And then the whole timeline of villa, like, you were never given an explicit timeline, except for, it is winter, we're waiting for the thaw, and we don't know how much time has passed. We know that they don't get to the thaw, but there's just like no concept of time at all. So I don't know how long she'd been staying with this family or how assimilated she would have gotten into the culture, because from my perspective, she'd been there for like a week. And speaking of that short timeline, let me get into the last point of why I hate this book, which is the enemies to lovers romance. I love enemies to lovers. I really do. And I promise I do. But man, this was not good. There are certain things I'm willing to excuse in an enemies to lover arc because it is that kind of arc and it comes with certain tropes that you kind of just have to look past and forgive. This is not that. She straight up got stabbed by this man, had an arrow shot through her shoulder by this man, was sold into slavery by this man, and he never released her from that collar that he knew, because she told him explicitly how much it pained her and went against her religion and made her feel like she was not going to get into her version of heaven. Like, oh my god. And then there was no character development, and she just kept being a dick to him the whole time. And then, like, he didn't talk to her. Like, the first time they really hung out was when he took her fishing with him and a bear happened to like her. That's it. A bear happened to like her. And then his complete perspective of her changed because I guess the bear symbolized his god or something. And you know me, I think that a person should only like someone romantically if their god gives them a direct sign through a bear that they approve of this person. It just wasn't good. There was no development. There was no getting to know each other. They just suddenly kissed after she found out her dad was dead? What? Oh my god, it's just... He outwardly told her at one point that, hey, I might like you and I might have kissed you, but I'm willing to kill every one of your tribesmen that is around me right now, and I'll do what I have to go back to my tribe to let them know to just kill all of you and tell them directly where your refugees are. And she was just kind of like, cool, if that comes to that, I'll kill you. And then that was it. It never came to anything, because of course it didn't, because that would include plot or anything, thought into anything. It's just like, they never seemed to have any chemistry at all, or banter or wit or personalities that meshed, other than I guess the fact that they lacked a personality. So I guess that was a great fit there. Good job. But it was just not good. And there was no romance that was written well in this. And I don't get it. I don't get it. Why do people like this book? Why does it have a 4-star on Goodreads? What is that? I don't know. And I would generally like to say here that I love YA. I do love YA fantasy. I have plenty of series that are YA fantasy that I genuinely do like. And so this doesn't have anything to do with the writing style. It doesn't have anything to do with the specific YA tropes. It has to do with how everything is executed, and specifically how the 5 things I mentioned were executed, because they're just not done well. You can be YA fantasy and write an amazing book with all of those tropes and do it just so well. It wasn't done well. It was not good. And I also will say here that I have not read any of her other books, so I don't know how I feel about those. I don't know if this was a one-off or I just really hated this book that she wrote and I would maybe prefer other ones like Fable. I just know this ain't it. This ain't it. Anyway, that is my rant review of Sky in the Deep by Adrienne Young. If you guys have any thoughts about this that are different than mine, definitely let me know. I would love to have some arguments against some of the points I made, because I feel like sometimes I do miss things. Or on the contrary, if you really did hate this book and you kind of agree with what I said, or you have anything more to add, drop that in the comments as well, because I think I'm going crazy. Am I the only one who hates this book? My crazy ramblings aside, at the end of the day, these are all my own opinions. You loving this book is totally fine and valid. I just really hated it, and that is, again, from my own experiences. I do not want anyone to belittle each other from not liking or really liking this book. At the end of the day, I just like to hear myself talk, and that's all that it is. All right, that's it, guys. I will see you in the next video.